Welcome guys, let's see what this question is saying is, there is a 4-year-old boy who was brought to the hospital with several episodes of vomiting. The boy's mother reports that he was playing in a local park prior to the onset of illness, and with cleaning him after the first episode of vomiting, she found several small brown mushrooms clenched in his hand. She has brought the sample with her. The boy is otherwise healthy and takes no medication. He is intubated due to somnolence and admitted in the intensive care unit. Analysis of the mushroom sample determines that the main poison stimulating the muscarinic receptors was there. Which of the following is the most direct effect of the poison? Now see, the mushroom poisons, there are several types. There are several types, and what they are discussing in this question is, let's see this details of the question, then we'll go to the options. See, we have various types of mushroom poisons. The poison that they are currently talking about, that is with the name of muscarine. Now what this muscarine toxin will do is, muscarine is a toxin that stimulates the muscarinic receptors of the parasympathetic system. Muscarine toxin stimulates muscarinic receptors of parasympathetic system, means it is going to stimulate the M receptors, which are called as muscarinic receptors. Particularly, this muscarine toxin affects the M2 receptors and the M3 receptors. M2 and M3 receptors are going to be stimulated by this muscarine toxin. See, the M2 receptors are found in heart. And once they are stimulated, there is going to decrease in the contractility, or I can say decrease in the heart rate. So this is one of the manifestations that you are going to see in this patient, that he will have bradycardia. Along with that, the M3 receptors are found in several places, and one of them is blood vessel. In the blood vessel, they are particularly found in the endothelium. Now this endothelium contains nitric oxide. So when this endothelium will be stimulated, the nitric oxide will come out. And once the nitric oxide will come out, we know that nitric oxide is a potent vasodilator. And the secondary messenger for the nitric oxide, it is the cyclic GMP. Via the cyclic GMP, it will lead to vasodilation, and that will manifest as hypotension. So this kid is having bradycardia with hypotension. Along with that, these M3 receptors are not just only found in blood vessel, they are also found in the detrusor muscles of the bladder. So they will lead to the contraction of the detrusor muscle. Even these M3 receptors are there in the pupils, and they will lead to meiosis. When they are stimulated, they will lead to meiosis. So these are the manifestations that we are going to see in this kid. One is, there is decrease in the heart rate. Second is, there is hypotension because of the nitric oxide released from the endothelium. There will be detrusor contraction as well as the meiosis because of the pupillary constriction. So they are asking that what is happening in this kid is, what is the most direct effect of this poison is, let's go by option by option. Detrusor muscle relaxation, no, it is the detrusor muscle contraction that is going to occur. Increased myocardial contractility, no, that is decrease, it leads to bradycardia, we have written that. Nitric oxide synthesis, yes, this is the direct effect that you are going to see, and that will manifest as hypotension. The pupillary dilation not occur, it leads to pupillary constriction, the M3 receptors. So the answer to this question is going to be nitric oxide synthesis. The remaining ones are in the opposite direction, right? So answer to this question is nitric oxide synthesis. Here I want to add one more statement, that this is the common toxin that you have, that is muscarine. There is one more toxin that you can find in mushroom. Another type of toxin that can be there, that is with the name of alpha amantin. That is another toxin. Now what alpha amantin works is, alpha amantin is an inhibitor of RNA polymerase 2. RNA polymerase 2. So we have discussed two toxins. One is muscarine, which is very common. The second is alpha-amantine, and how it works is it inhibits the RNA polymerase too. Thank you, guys.